Okay, I got here at the end of the train. Let's go and try to check out the trail I'm telling you about. Okay, I told you guys I was going to make a video about this crossover piece. This crossover piece right here is no good anymore. On the bottom, there's a bow. Do you see how this thing is going like a snake? That's from the massive amount of weight from the freight truck chain coming down there. I don't know if it's the 1, 2, 3, 4, the fourth or the fifth bolt is loose. You see, this is still made out of wood. This wood in here, this one is split, right? I don't know how long this thing has been here, right? But like I said, I don't know. We're going to catch another freight train. I'm going to cut this off. But that crossover is no good anymore. Can you guys see the twist in that? It goes on the bottom like that, right? Okay. And when, I'm going to show you guys, when the train comes by, some of those cars, some of the rolling stocks, they have two containers on there. Each container is 80,000 pounds. Two of them is 160,000 pounds. I mean, it sounds good and everything. When I'm making videos and the train comes by and hit that rail and you hear the 160,000 pounds hit that rail, it sounds mega, but this is a very dangerous situation. And what I'm going to do is, because where I live, they have an Amtrak workshop. I seen these guys cutting some rail the other day. I was videotaping them, and I lost the footage because I deleted while I was uploading it to YouTube. But anyway, I'm going to take this video down and a couple of other of my videos. If you look at all of my videos that I filmed in this area, when you see those CSX diesels, or the Norfolk diesel come and hit that rail, it is a tremendous, it's almost an echo. And that goes on. I didn't even think these guys was rolling freight on Sunday. These guys are 7 days a week bringing each container 160,000 pounds hitting that rail. I can look at the top of the rail right now and show you that it has a crown going this way. This rail. Because this rail right here goes to that aluminum place I was telling you guys about before. They didn't really use this rail that much. But anyway, that's a serious rail right here. That's where the freight cars come by, okay? And you can actually hear the squeaking. I can see the bolt. You guys cannot see it, Friday, with this camera. It's not good. That one of those bolts over there is loose, okay? So playtime is over. I'm going down there tomorrow to Amtrak dudes, man. I'm going to show them a video of this here. I'm going to show them a video, man, of one of them CSS, one of them Norfolk diesels coming down and hitting that rail, wah-bow! The front trucks, the back trucks, wah-bow! Sometimes you have three of them on there at one time. And then when the rolling stock comes through, you can hear it smashing on that rail constantly. And actually, that rail is chipped. You see in the middle of that crossover there? That piece is chipped inside of there. This is serious operation. Playtime is over. I'm trying to get as close as I can, man, to show you guys what the hell I'm talking about. You got the right guy, okay? Me snooping around, I'm gonna solve riddles. I don't care if I show this to these guys down there, 10 guys or 10 people, and they tell me, say, yo, the thing is all right. No, it's not all right. The fucking rail needs to be changed. This is wood. I don't know how long it's been here, maybe 100 years, 150 years. The thing on the top says Beth Shelton, 1996. That 1996 to be some kind of code or whatever it is, because on this one it says 1997. But anyhow, if we catch one of those bad boys coming through here right now, I'm going to stand right here and let you hit this rail. This is not a safe place. Not even for the guys driving the damn train. You don't want to, you know, they're beeping the horn for me now. I got a guy, you got a guy here, you got a good guy out here, man. He's trying to look out for you guys, man. Like I told you, it takes guys like me. And I know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about? This is the area, guys, you don't come around. They don't know what's going on. I came up here filming trains. I didn't figure it out. Why every time the damn train comes by, it smashed that rail like that? Just morning, I was at the Amtrak High Speed Rail. They got crammed, they replaced that with concrete. They got that same crossover piece. The same crossover piece there, because whenever you have a switch track, you gotta put that crossover piece over there. That thing, the Amtrak goes across there smoothly. Supposed to switch. It's not supposed to come and go in like this and out. Not at all. Because now that's going to affect the damn train switching. That's a switch track. That's so important. That's changing the thing. If that thing goes off the fucking rail, the train comes from this way, right? And then it switches the track this way. If it goes this way or this way, doesn't matter. If it goes this way, it's no stopping this fucking guy. Okay, excuse my language. That way, wherever is the problem, okay? So I'm going to show this video to the Amtrak workers by my house. I'm going to take this. I'm going to video me going over there because I know that I'm going over a place that the dudes, when they see my video, they're going to understand what I'm talking about. They know track, and they're going to be like, yo, bro, you are absolutely right, man. That the integrity on that rail is no good. Especially for the megalos that come through here. Wow. Man, the wait on that rail. Today's Sunday. This is 7-day operation with that rail. If you ask me, that rail needs to be changed every year. All of them. With that type of activity. Yeah. You're going to see. If you catch one of those guys coming through right now, I'm going to show you, man. The tremendous, wow. And that, you got to do 300 cars. Some of these guys got 200 cars, 250 cars. They has to do that 200 times. And then when the train comes across the rail, it comes down. That's where you got that bow going this way. It pushes it down. They don't have a shim or anything in there. And this type of operation, you shim nothing. This whole thing has to be changed. You shim nothing like this at all. So that crossover has to be replaced. I don't care what they say to me. I don't care what they say. Maybe we might catch a train. Sunday night might be running as secretly as I'm saying. But yes, I want you guys to take a look at that rail. Not jiving. Not fucking jiving around. It's not a fucking game here. The bows are on the bottom. And that thing is twisting like a snake almost. But anyway, that rail goes over here. But we can't see the other rail on the other side, what the integrity on that is. No, not at all. There's a switch track down here. You guys should get a better understanding of what I'm talking about. The hell with the train. I feel a little unsafe up here when the fucking train's up here now. Knowing, discovering this damn riddle. Yeah, that's a switch track over there. It stays to this side so the train can pull left. Now, like I told you, I followed this rail down there. This guy's got some scrap metal, some... You know what? Nah, they didn't do anything with that thing. It's still folded up with aluminum over there. Okay? They don't use this rail. I haven't seen them using this rail, and I've been out here a couple of times. This rail right here. Don't use this too much. But anyhow, if I catch one of these bad boys, I'm getting ready to cut this video. Right? But anyhow, the next train comes through, because I'm only filming one today. And the purpose of me filming the train today is to show you how that train goes up against that rail. The tremendous drop. Man, that thing cannot hold any longer. I don't know how old it is or whatever, what type of operation you got going over here to check on the track and all that. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 17 bolts. On the crossover at the high-speed rail, I was over there today. You have like 20 over there. But anyhow, the train, the Amtrak train, when it goes across that crossover, it grows smooth. It's very important. This is how a train goes off the track when it's fucking switching. It can go off the track when it's on the regular two rails, but it's more probable when there's a fucking switch track. It has to go, excuse my name, it's go across the switch track. And this switch track right here, this crossover, is no good. Get what they say. I don't know if you don't have a train coming down here. I'm filming one trade, man, one of these cargo things, and I'm gone. Just missed one. I didn't get the front of it. Tried to get over there quicker, but I got my orientation twisted up to actually where the rail was. Because when the train's on top of it, it's hard to figure out where the spot is really important. Anyhow, I know what I know. This rail's no good, man. Those tankers, man, they got gas inside those tankers, flammable material, and all kind of stuff, man, inside those tankers. You understand? And this old-fashioned, archaic rail, it served its purpose. Good craftsmen that designed it or whatever, you know, I don't know how old it is. It's a good question. But I know they haven't been doing no work over here because these are still wood. You know, they didn't change it over to the concrete. You know, but in any event, I want you guys to see today, man. I hope a train come down here, man. How, when the train goes over, this thing comes down. 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 Goes up and down. Up and down. And that's the reason why you got that bow in the bottom. And you can't have a bow in that. At all. You can't have a bow in there, man. Especially not with this type of operation you got going on with this mega freight. I don't think you guys should hang out with me. You know, these guys are making videos and stuff. I just popped up on the scene with this kind of stuff here. But I don't think these guys should hang out with me with this type of mother load that come through here. This is it. Because the port is over there. Newark Port. And they also have Elizabeth Port. And that's where these guys is bringing these container ships from. They're bringing it from the port. So this is a busy thing here. You know, I walked down here today. I didn't have to film a train. I just came down here to show you guys that I know what I know about this rail. And I'm taking this information over there to these Amtrak dudes that work on the track. And I'm going to tell them, I said, listen, man, you want to be a hero, man? Right now, I know you're at work and everything. I'm going to show you a video, man. You know about tracks. This track, the integrity is on this track. You want to come over to, take you over to the location, I'll show you the video. Get over here and be a hero, man. Okay, and get your medal. Because this thing here is no good. Trust me when I tell you. It's done. That rail is done. Train's not supposed to be coming down on that rail like that. You watch a couple of my videos. In a couple of my videos, I got the phone, the video, right next to that rail. And then you would understand what I'm talking about. You might not be able to see that boat shaking because of, you know, the lens and stuff like that in my camera. You might not be able to see that a boat shaking. But one of them boats is loose. One of these boats is loose in there, man. One of them boats is loose. I'm not jiving out of it. So I'm getting ready to cut this phone off. The next time I cut it on, we're going to be filming the train coming across that fucking crossover.